Okay, so I have decided to go ahead and start streaming here. And so what I'm doing is, first of all, you can see I still haven't put my green screen back up. I'm so busy with work and school. I don't feel it right now. So today I am going to be doing very much the same thing. This is going to be from Chico down to McClellan, and you can see it's relatively short flight. We're gonna go up here to 15,000 feet and come into McClellan. They're 16 runway. We're gonna take off from Chico 13 KCIC 13 and pull on into McClellan's 16. Should be a relatively uneventful flight. And this is happening in real time. So I made some changes to my checklist. That's why you see that up on screen. So let's go ahead and get into it. I still can't get all of the things mapped to. So for instance, I can't map fuel boost to any of the buttons I have here. So I got to figure out how that might work long term. Let's get our fuel selectors turned on. Let's go ahead and our parking brake is set. You can see it right there. Power lever is set to idle. Battery switch is off. Avionics is off. And I'm gonna reset my camera here real quick. There we go. Okay, a little bit better. Okay. Flaps are retracted. RPM, let's go ahead and let's go out max on the RPM. Fuel control is cut off. I just set that to cut off. Fuel shutoff valve is open. And let's go ahead and start firing the
System test.
airplane.
Okay.
Okay. We're gonna reverse engineering mode doesn't work, so that's why I go ahead and turn on avionics 1 and 2 because reverse engineering mode's not working, so I can't do anything without it. Let us get back to our checklist here and let's check our flight controls. So we're gonna look outside here in a second, but you can see. Looks like everything is functioning as we expect it would. So let's get back inside and complete that. So let's tune up. Chico is 121.9. Let me bring up G1000 so you can see what I'm doing here. So Chico's, we're gonna go 121. I'm sorry. I know ground is 121.9, so actually I'm gonna go ahead and get that set. But then I'm going to set ATIS to 119.675 and go ahead and get some automated weather since we will need that first. Okay. So let's get our automated weather going. While we're doing that, we're going to KMCC. So I'm going to put the localizer in for that 109.7. As you can see, we have our altimeter set for 3037. I do have Nav1 programmed for 109.7. That's the localizer down at KMCC. I'm also going to on COM2. I'm going to put automated weather in for KMCC, and that's 125.975. So we'll get that tuned in. So that's on COM 2. It's loaded up and ready to go. We are going to set the minimums down there for that guy is 280 feet. It's actually 277 on the plate, but we'll make it 280. And go ahead and turn that on for barometric. So we are set for CDI. Let's go ahead and I've got my altimeter altitude set for 5,000 feet. That's going to be our cruising altitude. And let's go ahead and get this set for 130. Since 130 is the runway that we're going to be taking off from. So heading bug is set. Let's work on our transponder now once we go ahead and get... Oops, sorry. I said I didn't. So let's get back to our checklist here. And get some... let's get started. And get ready to go. So I'm going to... I'll get rid of this so you can see what I'm doing. Okay. The ignition is set to normal, power level still idle, and max is our RPM is set to max. Battery switch is on, beacon is on. Now they are. Prop area is clear. Those guys never leave. Let's go ahead and mixture rich. Okay. Fuel shutoff valve is still open, and let's go ahead and hit our fuel boost and set our starter motor. Okay, once we're started, we'll bring our condition to. Okay, so we'll bring our condition to low idle, right about there. Set our starter to off. These are buttons I can't map on to any of my equipment here. So Avionics 2 is already on. We'll go ahead and check our instruments here, make sure everything is in the green and where we expect it to be. Engine fuel flow, fuel quantity, bus volts. We see we've got oil temperature on the rise. PSI is within range, and let's just make sure our gauge, our steam gauges, agree with everything that we see around us. And I see that they do. We'll check on this gauge once we get going, but everything else is agreeing. So, continuing through our checklist here, let's set fuel boost back to normal. And we have nothing to respond to. So, I brought in our program from Little Nav Map. So, I do not have... So, I brought in the program here from Little Nav Map. So I know that it's correct, my flight plan's correct, and for, I need to change my, I think I want to get, at this point, I want to make sure that I get clearance, IFR clearance at this point. Chico ground, so I think I'm going to add that to my taxi list, or just before. It might be on the other taxi list now that I think about it. So let's go ahead and squawk. Okay. 0123. And acknowledge that.
Cessna November 4537 Sierra cleared to Kilo Mike Charlie Charlie Airport as filed.
We'll get rid of that.
Runway 13 right climb and maintain 5,000 feet. Departure on 132 decimal 2 squawk 0123.
Cessna 37 Sierra, read back is correct. Contact ground on 121 decimal 9er when ready to taxi.
Okay. Okay, so it looks like we are all ready to go. Let's go ahead and... Okay, so checklist complete. All of our radios are set. All of our... transponder set. Everything's ready. Let's get some taxi clearance.
Chico ground, Cessna November 4537 Sierra, with Echo ready to taxi IFR.
Cessna November 4537 Sierra taxi to in hold short of runway 13 right. Contact tower on 121 decimal 0 when ready.
Okay, 1210 when ready.
Taxi to in hold short runway 13 right, Cessna 37 Sierra.
Okay, so I got 1210 loaded up for our next contact. So let's go ahead and get ready to get going here. Let's release parking brake. Okay, hello. Okay, there we are. And we'll test our brakes along the way here as we make our way. Okay, brakes are working. Okay, our heading indicator is working. I feel like this is speeding along. I'm supposed to be going to 13 right. Okay, that's okay, I can get there from here. So 13 right is across 13 left, and I'm pretty sure that's no. Yeah, it might be the next. Next entrance taxiway. I'll see here in a second. They don't have these marked, and I don't have the map up. Actually, I do. I got a little nav map up. I could just, I don't know, have a look at it. But no. What am I doing? I'm being at ID 10T. Yeah, this is that was it. That was the taxiway for 13 right, which is fine. I'll just go around, not go around. I am super glad I'm at Chico and I'm not, I know Sacramento, KMC, KSMF, and KSAC more than I know Chico. This is I've only done a couple of flights out of here. So, I don't really know the airport, but I'll get there. Over time, I will get there. I would love to study the map, but as I said, you know, being busy with school and stuff. Okay, let's see, we got anybody? Nope. So this is 13 right. Okay. Check our fuel selectors, still both on. Fuel quantities still checks. All of our instruments are where we want them to be. We are at max RPM. We're trimmed. Takeoff. Condition lever is full rich. Flaps are set for takeoff. Flight controls are still free and correct. Nothing to respond to. Radio is set. Avionics. Landing light is on. Strobe lights are on. Pitot heater. Even though it's 12 degrees, it is on. Transponder is set. And let's go ahead and get some clearance from air traffic.
Chico Tower, Cessna November 4537 Sierra, ready to go runway 13 right IFR to Kilo Mike Charlie Charlie.
Cessna November 4537 Sierra, cleared for takeoff runway 13 right.
Cleared for takeoff runway 13 right, Cessna November 4537 Sierra.
Okay. shoot for 1800 RPM. We are going to release our parking brake. We're going to rotate it approximately 76 indicated. We're going to pitch up for 10 degrees, set our trim, and then once we are have positive rate of climb, we'll go ahead and retract flaps and engage autopilot. Okay, and we're going to engage autopilot. But we'll be back to that checklist once we are in route. Okay, spinning it up. Okay, releasing a brake. Okay, we'll visit our next checklist once we hit cruising altitude, 5,000. Beautiful day. at how it's, look at the deviation. Look at how it's, we're clearly off course. I'm not going to screw around with it because I want to see where this goes. But that is different. Obviously, there's something going on with the sim. It's not a wind problem. We are way off course. I don't know what it could be. Am I stupid? Did you see it? Even though when I invoked autopilot, I set it for nav, it went to heading. So I'm like, why are we going so far? Of course, what's happening here? I guess that's what happens when you don't have your system set correctly. So I just put it back to nav and now it's course correcting for going back to Dashi. So it's gonna intersect and then course correct again. Truth is, I should have seen that sooner. It's a little colder than I anticipated, so I turned on stall heat. You need to have it on it. -4 Celsius, and it's currently -2. Not that it'll get there, but that's CL23. 07 CL. CL23 is 3.8 nautical miles away. I'm an idiot. Like, why are we deviating? Oh my god. You weren't. It was flying your course heading. see what the outside looks like. Yep, that's about right. If I had done my checklist, I would have picked that up, seen it. But no, not me. No weather yet from KMCC. Get it when we're about 19 miles, I think, to away from dashing. Excuse me. Ah. I'd really like to get back to wireless headphones. just gotta... message from my phone to, get to studying. It's my study time.
ILS runway 16 approach by Dashi transition cleared to Dashi Cessna 37 Sierra.
Kilo Mike Charlie Charlie, automated weather observation 1900 Zulu. Wind 18555. Visibility 10. Sky condition few clouds at 700 feet, few clouds at 4300 feet, few clouds at 11900 feet. Temperature 12C dew point 10C altimeter.
So, they're going to send us down to 3,000 feet here, once we get a little bit closer here, so just a few minutes actually. The other thing that's not working is my VNAV button on my G1000. Excuse me. What I should do is sell my radio stack and get a new button stack. I know as soon as I pick this phone up, it's going to be, they're going to give me new directions. Let's do three of those. Hey, do I have a coupon? Let's check. I do not.
1.27.4 for Cessna 37 Sierra. Normal approach Cessna November 4537 Sierra is out of 3,600 feet for 3,000 feet.
Cessna November 4537 Sierra NorCal approach. Continue to dash as planned. Altimeter tree 0.36.
So I'm just tweaking the throttle here. Okay, we'll be going down to 2200 in a short order.
Cessna 37 Sierra.
So I've armed approach and glide slope. I've got our first notch of flaps set. We will be handed off to the tower here in just a minute. Position.
Kilo Mike Charlie,
landing light on fuel selector both.
0 miles north inbound ILS runway.
Fuel boost. Let's go ahead and turn it on. Okay. Max RPM. Condition lever is full rich. We don't have. Let's go ahead and pull inertia step on. We'll set flaps here in just a second for touchdown, and everything else is ready to go. It's going to be just a normal landing, about 85 knots main first, and we're going to apply reverse thrust once we hit the ground. So once we start making the descent here, I'm going to put that last notch of flaps on and pull back a little bit on the throttle. And we are coming up on it. Since we're on the localizer and glide slope is active, so last notch of flaps activated. And we'll throttle up for 85 knots. Okay, we're gonna announce final. Actually, once we pass Widow. Widow's the final approach fix. Widow. Okay, announcing final.
Kilo Mike Charlie Charlie traffic Cessna November 4537 Sierra is on final runway 16 to land.
Okay, and we are configured for landing. Looking good. Okay, we're going to take over at 500. And again, we'll turn autopilot off. We're going to shoot for about 85 knots indicated. We're going to touch down main wheels first, apply reverse thrust. Looking good. Obviously, we've got visibility to the runway. That was 277 feet. .30-36 was the pressure for this location. Sorry about all the head movement. Okay, coming up on 570, so autopilot off. Still on slope. Okay, reverse thrust. Good landing. Our clearance runway.
Kilo Mike Charlie Charlie, traffic Cessna November 4537 Sierra is clear of the runway.
That was a good landing. Get for trying to do like more than one thing at once.